Siyahamba manje siyedeben fact Durban rocks bafethu inakho-ke iSpani bafethu sihloma amatende for inyanga yonke ngasihamba sinikhombisa-ke amathuba omsebenzi atholakala ngakhona ngithi sanibonani dumelani molweni abusheni helda and mama stay ngabe nganaso isikhathi bafethu ngandulisa ngawonke amalimi atholakala khona la emvansi ngithi salute all my hustlers igama umekubelelishumo bafethu uhlelo iSpani ngithi silaphana-ke kuma-workshop bafethu khala insimbi khala umsindo siyasebenza sambona hasa lethu ukavish insizwa-ke efisa ukuba i-marine millwright bafethu you know what they say there's a lot of fish in the sea kodwa ukavish athi ukavish guy one akekho omunye akahlangane naye ukuthi ayichaze kabanzi
my name is kavish Shabanchal. I am 28 years old. We used to play cricket a lot. That was my favorite at that time.
Kavish, as a little boy, he was a very soft, kind-hearted, compassionate child. When there was not a day that I can complain to, you know, I got a complaint that he's been mischievous at school. Well, at home, you know, with the siblings, they used to get down to their normal routine of misbehaving, but nothing serious.
In the year 1993, I was enrolled at my first school, which was called Clayton Primary School in Overport. On completion of my matric, I had already known what field I was going to pursue the following year, as I had already applied in various institutions to pursue my career in mechanical engineering.
If he decided on choosing a career or what he wanted to, like he chose mechanical engineering, we gave him the go-ahead and we told him, you do what you want to do in your field and what you're capable of. Because sometimes a child cannot fulfill a parent's dream. And you know, they do not want to disappoint the parents at the end of the day. So they are forced to do, you know, choose a career that they are not happy with. So it was a choice that he had made and we had given him the full support. I think Kavish got his ethics from his dad because his dad has been always been, he's been busy in and around the house, always repairing, you know, things if something's giving a problem, he's busy there. So Kavish used to be with him, always wanting to know what are you doing, how are you doing it and why you're doing it. And he wanted to learn. So he used to also give a hand to his dad. In repairing.
During my second year of studies, I was doing my N5 course and I had come across the transit vacancy for an apprentice post in the National Ports Authority. And this was, I just knew it straight away, it was an opportunity as I had met the requirements. And ever since, I never regretted applying and taking on this opportunity. Okay. Shortly after applying for this ad, I was contacted by Transnet for an interview, and a few days after that I had been notified I had been successful.
As a parent to Kavish, I am very proud. I can always be, you know, praising him because he's been working his way up from an apprentice right up until what he is today, a qualified millwright. and he's still studying to better himself in the future.
Tomorrow I'm going to Transnet to be interviewed in the vacancy for being a millwright tutor at the training center.
When Kavish is going to the interview, I will firstly give him my blessings, and then I will tell him, you give it your best.
Should I get this position, it will be a milestone achieved. It will be a step closer to getting where I want to be, which is teaching the newcomers, our industry, transferring skills and passing on knowledge to all employees who join Transnet.
So I've just walked into the TNPA Workshop 24 building where the interview is going to be conducted. I feel quite confident and ecstatic. I hope all goes well for me today, and we'll see by the end of the day how it goes.
Good day, Mr. Avanchar. Welcome to Workshop 24. As you know, you were called here for the interview for the millwright tutor post. I just need to take you through some formalities before we actually go into the actual questionnaire. As you know, there's two parts to this interview.
Yes.
The first part will consist of the actual practical tasks that were set out as a millwright, okay, which you need to demonstrate competencies. And then this part, which is the actual formal interview, which is a questionnaire process, is also part of the interview process. And we need to do both in order for us to have a decision on whether or not we'll be the suitable candidate for this vacancy. Are you okay?
Yeah.
Good. Just some things I need you to take heed of before we actually go into the actual questions as well, is this is a formal process as set out by HR, recruitment and selection. And we're going to make detailed notes. I'm going to be making detailed notes of your responses. So in no way should you feel intimidated that I'm not listening to you at everything. I mean, it's just a part of the process. Are you comfortable?
Yes, I am.
Good. The fact that you've applied for the tutor post as a millwright, one of the first questions I have for you is, you need to tell me a little bit about yourself and more especially focus on your duties as a millwright in your years here in Transnet.
Can I have some time just to think about it? I began in Transnet as a millwright apprentice. I've obtained a 75% pass at the end of my training. And thereafter, I've been positioned in the port of Durban as a millwright in the ship repair department. During my time in this department, I've had the opportunity to work on major projects on the tugboats and dredgeships. And recently, I have been awarded with the opportunity to lead such projects in some new environments.
And during this time, can you name me one or two highlights of your apprenticeship, something that you could be very proud of?
I've obtained a B aggregate pass, a 75% pass in majority of my modules. So that is quite an achievement for me.
Great. Your career in transit, and more especially in the dockyard, some of your milestones that you've achieved here as an artisan?
Like I mentioned earlier, I've recently been awarded with opportunities to lead projects at this age. I believe that it's a great achievement to be able to lead a team. And the opportunity to study and to further develop myself as a millwright is also quite beneficial there.
What is a very key sort of factor that you've got to take into when you work in transit as a whole? I think, as you know, there's a big focus on it, and also the fact that you're going to be this future millwright tutor. What is absolutely key when you do conduct these duties?
I'd say safety. In every task that we conduct, safety is the utmost importance. Because no matter how big or how small the task is, safety is applicable in any condition.
Okay. As you know, transit is a parastatal, and we work in a very regulated environment. Can you just name me one or two legislative or governance issues or acts that you are aware of that we abide to?
I'd say the Labor Relations Act, Employment Equity Act.
Anything revolving around training?
The bursary policies, but that's internal.
It's fine, it's applicable, you'll be covering that as well. When we select a service provider for training, it is absolutely crucial that we do certain things, and more especially around quality. What do you think those things are? One is what you said, we need to be, the service provider needs to be listed. Anything else that comes to mind?
The quality, they should have a good background, a good history of the services that they have provided, and to ensure that it's gonna promote continuous improvement.
Okay, great. Why, of all the occupations in transit, or more especially TNPA, and maybe we alluded to this before, but just give me your reasons from your experiences or whatever you want to reflect on. Why do you want to become a millwright training officer?
Okay, due to my experience prior to working in Transnet, from schooling days, I used to assist a lot of my classmates in regards with my strengths, like at school it was in my technical field. And at Transnet, I tend to pass on my skills and knowledge to new workers and apprentices, and I enjoy doing that. Watching them follow
so
my footsteps to teaching and transferring of my skills, yeah.
Before we close, are there any questions that you would like to ask the panel members or myself, in this case, myself?
Not really, but I'd like to thank you for the opportunity for having me here.
Dintlha tse hulang bahiri tse eleng gore o ka di mention ko dipotsong tsa gago tse ka ha Kavish a entse mentiona dintho tse eleng gore di phahame tse o di thupileng bua ka experience ya gago bokgoni ba gago ba o etsela pele wa iponagatsa gore Kavish wa tlameha go tseba go gongata ka tsa dikwetliso le tsa polokego mahaslase ka nnete re na le tlhokagalo ya di-artisan tse eleng gore di qualified ba leng teng se ba godile and ha se ba ya pensioneng tlhokagalo ya rona e tlo gola di millwright bona ke batho ba eleng gore ba lokela ba lukisa metšhini e meholo e sebetsang di-industry ka go fapana Transnet le ba Ports Authority ba na le program e ba e bitsang phakisa mo e leng gore ba phatalalatsa mesebetsi ya trade makaleng a bona and-e tseba gore ga se o na le career o na le di-skills o tseba career eo ka ntle le ka gare o na le bokgoni le menyetla ya gore o ka e rutisa kapa wa e kwetlisa menyetla ya career ya gago ga e felele fela matsogong a gago o ka e eketsa wa tseba le o eketsa tšhelete jeka ga di-millwright le tsona di batlagala go tla rutisa ba tlang
Hustlers, as a business, you get to change and gain the life, especially about the job, success, and data, and cutting the manager. ubheka ke idingo ze-business uma kuza kudaba labasebenzi udinga ke abasebenzi ke abafana ke njengonwabo abakwazi ukushintsha abayenze into eyiningi ngesikhathi esodwa abaqashi ke sokuyinto abayibhekayo ke impilo beqasha abantu badinga abantu abakwazi ukwenza into eyiningi ehlukene sokuyinto engenile umcabango ke ukwenza ke i-short term contracts wenza ke imisebenzi eminingi ehlukile into ke ongayijabulela noma ke kufaka uvalo noma ke uthukele ukuthi ngeke ke uthole umsebenzi phawulani khona lapha ku Twitter na ku Facebook njengamanje
I'm Sylvia CEO and I've been working in Transnet for the past 16 years. My tenure started as an apprentice in 1997, which was the first entry of apprentices in Transnet. My journey through being an apprentice took 4 years and it's a diesel electrical trade, which took place in Transnet Rail Engineering. It was both mechanical and electrical. And we worked in the diesel locomotive industry. Since my apprenticeship, I qualified and became an artisan and one of the first female artisans that were successful in the year 2001. Welcome, Kavish. This is the second phase of your assessment. You'll be doing 3 tasks and one of the first tasks is about rigging. So as you know, millwrights, their main or most of their functions are rigging. So we'll start the process from a forklift operation, lifting a live raft and then bringing it safely into the workshop and using the overhead cranes to do that. And you do know that safety plays a critical role in that activity.
Always, yeah.
So I'm expecting you to execute the task from start to finish, putting safety in mind.
Do not give a man a fish, but teach a man how to fish. Ngimthusa ukuthi ke ihasta sabana namuhla bafethu uKavish bafethu njengoba ke kuyinsizwa efisa ukuba i marine millwright. Ngisikhathi sakho sokuphumula bafethu iyathanda ukuya ngalapha ngaselwandle yodoba ke inhlanzi bafethu. Ngimthusa ukuthi iyasazi lesisho phinde futhi iphila ngaso. Insizwa ke esikhombisa inogqozi nofuqufuqu iphinde futhi ithole isikhathi ukuthi ifundise abanye abantu. But something smells fishy, not because we're close to the sea bafethu. It is that time ukuthi ninikeze the word jumbo. Njengendlela yenza bafethu nginikeza amathu amabini bafethu which are your letters T and S. Uthumela lapha impendulo khona lapha na ku social media. But right now asambe sibona ke insizwa ke ishaya task yakhe yokuqala bafethu which is rigging. Ake ngithembe ukuthi he's ready for battle as he battles ships.
Kavish, this is part of your activities, or one of your first tasks. As you know, as a millwright, I don't have to tell you what are the things that we need to consider when working with equipment, and what would that be?
Firstly, we have to do our pre-start checks to make sure it's a good working condition.
Yes, proceed.
May I go ahead? Okay, thanks. We'll start off with the front forks. Okay, the forks are in good condition. There's no bends or cracks. As you can see, there's no leaks on our linkages and our cylinders. As we proceed to our wheels, see the tires are fully inflated, there ain't no leaks. As we come across down to our fuel tank, the cap is fully secure, there is no leaks on that. We check in the tire here, the pressure is fine, there's no leaks, no oil leaks from the bearing hub. Come across through to the hydraulic oil, the cap, the cylinder, there's no leaks, everything is fine here. Our pedals, there's no blockages, no obstructions from operations. As you come through to our last wheel, the air pressure is fine, there's no leaks here. The last cylinder, everything's all fine here. Task one, I was instructed to use the forklift. It's a sort of transport to move heavy equipment from outside the workshop to bring it down inside. Since it was a sensitive piece of equipment, I had to be really gentle and slow with it.
So Kavish, you are fully licensed to drive this forklift?
Yes, I am. I'm certified for vehicles up to 15 tons.
Up to 15 tons,
yeah.
Excellent. So then you are competent to then use this equipment?
Yeah, it's
proceed. Okay, I just require your permission.
You may proceed. A millwright is basically an industrial mechanic. They will execute functions of maintenance, whether it's on machinery or equipment. And generally, the training takes roughly 2.5 years for you to be able to be qualified for millwright. It has basically both mechanical and a few electrical activities also involved within the environment. The millwright trade is a well-known trade within the mechanical industry. It is of, you don't need to have tertiary education to get it, but most industries provide it. It's an apprenticeship training, which then involves a modular training process, meaning that you will have a tutor, you go through the theory side, links with the practical, and the practical has to be done in a workshop environment.
I once used my rigging abilities and my skills at home to rig in an engine into one of the vehicles. And whatever principles and rules I've learned, I've incorporated that into my duties and it's worked out fine.
Both the millwright and electromagnetician have the similar advantage. They're both exposed to the workshop environment, meaning equipment and tooling. But in a marine environment, the millwrights are slightly different in the marine environment based on the obvious reason. It's in water space. So that will mean that our millwrights will then have the opportunity to work on the crafts and the vessels and be exposed to quayside cranes, which they can also maintain, versus a person that works indoors in a workshop environment. Okay, Kavish, this is the next step of your activity. Because this is a sensitive vessel, you know that you need to move it quite efficiently, quite slowly, and safely to its final destination.
Yes, I'm aware of those.
Yes, so always keep in mind, safety first. You may proceed.
Rigging is really, it can be tricky at times. If you don't know what you're doing, you can end up in a real mess. Sometimes there's so much of rigging involved, it tends to look like a spider web. And eventually you work your way out of it. But it's good, it's a good experience to learn.
I think because it was the first task, the initial start was a bit nervous. He was a bit nervous. But once he got into the activity, his confidence boosted and he was able to execute the task quite fairly well, especially because the life craft is a sensitive equipment and you need to be very careful when moving it or lifting it. I think for task number one, he actually executed it fairly well.
Task one, I feel I've done it quite well. I've followed the procedures. I've done as required. I took safety precautions, done my checks, and I've moved the load as within specifications without jerking or bumping it, as it's a sensitive piece of equipment.
Kavish o bontsha a itshepa ka tsebo ya hae ya di safety checks and le experience ya hae ya iponahatsa. Ha e ka ba ona le kgatlhego lekaleng lena, o tlhoka at least grade 9. Maths e compulsory. Tse ding tsa di subjects tse ka o thusang ke yona physical science, technical drawing le trade theory. Lekala lena lena le karolo tse pedi. Ho na le theory, ho na le practical. Theory ya hao o tla e thola mane ko FET College. For the practicals, wa tlameha gore o ngodise le mohiri and o tla etsa tsena ka tlase ga a qualified tradesman. Ha se o qetile he, o tlameha go ngola trades test ya hao e netefatsang gore o ba a qualified artisan. Mahaslase, ra tseba gore menyetla ha iketsa ha le fela, rona re a ebopa. The millwrights tsona di na le di skills tse fapaneng and Kavish o tlameha go supa seo ha e ka ba o batla o kwetlisa ba bang.
Okay, Kavish, it seems like you've executed your first task quite effectively. Now we're going to go on to the next task, which is overhauling the steering hydraulic cooler. This will be done on board the vessel. You're well familiar with the activities on the craft. So what we will do then, you will make sure that you execute the task efficiently and effectively and safely. Let's proceed. Okay, Kavish, you've successfully completed your first task. Now it's the second task, which is the steering pump oil cooler. As you can clearly see, it's taking place within the vessel.
Yeah.
You're well aware of this activity. I will expect you to strip, clean, and inspect, and reassemble.
Sure.
Do it efficiently, safely, and as per SOP.
Okay.
You may proceed.
Okay, I'm going to start by removing, firstly we'll isolate all the oil and the water valves. Okay, that's shut off. We've got no water and oil in the system. We'll proceed by removing the two covers.
The basics, if you are in matric and you've just completed your studies, you should have at least had maths, pure maths. Physics, because, and also drawings, some sort of like basics of drawings, because mostly in the mechanical environment you need to understand and know how to do calculations, know how to read drawing.
Our environment can be stressful at times due to increasing workload. It's not consistent. Some days, some weeks we are quiet, some weeks we are really busy, and today will be quiet, the next day we just got a handful of work and we just have to manage it. We have to prioritize what comes first and slot it in as it comes, take it as it comes.
Okay, I'm inspecting the gasket at the same time. Okay, that's fine, it can be reused. Okay, I'm proceeding to the end cover.
As a female, there's not many challenges in terms of having to have any physical strength, because there are equipment that help to assist to execute the task. For example, we have hydraulic tooling. If a bolt or a nut is difficult to loosen, that hydraulic tooling will, if you set it to the right spec, it will help you to loosen the bolt. In terms of lifting, there are many other types of equipment that can be used to assist you. You've got chain blocks for small little riggings in workshop spaces. You've got your overhead cranes to assist you. You've got forklifts to assist you. So in terms of strength and difficulty of the jobs, there are machinery and equipment that can allow you to execute your task efficiently.
The gasket is still fine. It's still soft. It's not brittle. It can be reused, as you can see. The anode material here to protect the housing, that's still fine, it can be reused, it can go back as normal. And I can proceed with cleaning off those parts. I would enjoy this training position as I would be able to pass on my skills, meet new people, create new friendships, and pass on knowledge that I've learned from experienced artisans, and hopefully someday be able to view what I had transferred to other people in our industry. I'm proceeding by cleaning the potholes on the top. Got my water to flush out the grout that has formed in here. Okay, these holes are quite clean. Go to the next one.
So which types would you generally have problems with?
There's the big one for the main engines, which is just behind us that we pass on our way in. Those are used more on a regular basis, so.
Yeah, I think I would make a great tutor because I'm not one to just snap at students or lash out my frustration at anybody. I know how to take it easy, control the situation, and explain whatever difficulties anyone is going through.
So now what would you be expecting now by allowing that pressure of water to go through?
As you allow the water to go through, you have a look at this end, you see the water flowing through. And you can see it's uniform, flowing through each of the holes, each of the ports. So that tells you there's no blockages and it will be fine.
From what I've seen from Kavish and his dedication and how he executed his task and how he planned his task, those are all the tools that you need for you to be able to progress, meaning planning, organizing, and general efficiency, and also safety, because those are the key things that we steer as Transnet at all times in terms of efficiency, safety, and be able to execute and plan your activities. So in terms of growth, yes, if he follows and always sticks to that game plan, he can succeed in whatever he executes. So Kavish, you are saying that the surface area is perfect. What actually would you be looking for in mechanical terms?
As I was mentioning, you have a look at the surface. There's no corrosion, there's no cutting, there's no cracks to look for. If there was, you would have to take this off and send it for machining to the workshop. But it's fine. There's nothing wrong with it.
Good. Because in that area, firstly, it's a confined space. You need to be able to set out your equipment and your toolings correctly. The difficult part is to take your tools down the deck to the engine room, firstly, because obviously, depending on the task you need to execute, you need to prepare your tools before you go down.
If I do not happen to get this training position, I will go back and review where my weaknesses are. I will work on that and I will come back stronger, and next time I will get it. Okay, that was the completion of the cleaning of the potholes. Now we may proceed to reassemble. All these components are satisfactory, including the bolts, which I just had a browse through when I was removing.
So what would you check on a bolt, Kavish?
You check for any corrosion, if there's damaged threads or strip threads that can be replaced. Ideally, we use stainless steel bolts, so we don't have a problem in the future when we do the job again.
I think Kavish wanting to be a training officer is will suit him well. Firstly, because when he was executing the task, he was expressing himself, he was knowledgeable about the task, and he was confident while doing the task. When you're a training officer and you're presenting to your students, you as a trainer need to be confident and knowledgeable about your task so that your students can buy in and be able to absorb that knowledge that you're given. So in terms of what he executed today, I am sure and confident that he can be a good training officer.
In regards with task two, there were not any challenges because that is it's a sensitive component that is really maintained well during each layup. So if done properly on each layup, there will not be, okay, most of the time there will not be any problems reoccurring.
Mona Ribana Otame Hobana Lebuhoni Babutaba di components, Sebu Pamuchin, and a Kavishi, Usu Supi le Seu, Horo Obe Millwright, Otame Hobana Lema Carabello, Orata Josebe Sakamato, and Otebekaho Atiling, Kalika Lalena. House of Ole Millwright, Unalemunieta, Wahor Okaba Engineer, Technician, Plenara, Kapa Misebeti Eming Eva Tambuhoni, Libutibi, Bata Electrically, Limechanically. My Hustler, House of Humana Singh, Katala 18, Oskewanya Hama. Baba Mbarona, ditsela tsa rona ditelele empa tetelong di molemo. Ka morao ga mabenkele, Kavishi o re bontsha bokgoni ba gae ba go kgatlha le go gotlisetsa dintho tsa pampo.
Okay, Kavish, you've completed your two tasks. Now we're on to the third task. This is an underwater valve. You are well aware we have a layup in the dry dock. and one of the vessels is due for a underwater valve maintenance overhaul. So hence we've brought it into the workshop for you to proceed with the overhaul maintenance of the underwater valve.
Yep.
You may proceed with the task.
Rock the boat, work a little, get to okay, fish my face, so come to the woods. In this log, a rock and fella, pinna footy, it's a bizarre game, kumbi, in a sense of Umundi and Gamcham with Abitan and Gwam, Mangasolaga, Gumkumbi, or Vuzayo, Mabaka Uskomsi, Unalo, Iluazi, Gishoge, Nakon, Luxembourg, Izanda, we millwright a right of a face, but I see you are lost like Finding Nemo, so let me give you two more clues, my face, which are your letters R and A. But right now, I guess one would think I must wear M for okay for it. In this way, it's a colour. I'm a task wire. That was a teaser. Like a fisherman luring fish with the bait. I'll catch you after the break.
Kavish, you may proceed with your task.
Sure, thanks. Okay. Let me just rearrange my workstation. We start off, before we remove the handle, we need to loosen off this bolt so the bonnet can jack off so we can get to the components.
The general purpose of task 3 was to gauge how Kavish was able to follow a process from start to finish within a, I would say, limited time, because he would have to strip, inspect, clean, machine, and then reassemble it.
Being a part of this industry, which is part of our leading supply chain, I feel we all have a role to play in regards with exporting and importing. And by us keeping the ports operational, it allows an influx of ships to come and the continuation of warehousing, logistics, and all that associated with that operation. Now, in order to split this, we need to screw down the spindle so it jacks open.
In terms of how he executed and he planned out his tools and he planned out the layout of the job, that then made the task go more efficiently and easily. So in terms of his planning of the task and preparation, I would give him top marks for that.
Okay, this is the seat of the valve and it has a special locking device that keeps it in position. It has these two rings, it's called half moons. When it's in position, the screws in here and keeps it from getting displaced. I was required to strip down that valve, clean up each component and inspect all the vital parts. And on completion of inspection, I found that there weren't any defects to be fixed. So based on my experience, that valve was, you can say, 80% still good. And the only task that was remaining was to lap in or reseat the valve into its housing, which was done accordingly. And as you've seen, it will be now ready, waiting for SAMSA to come and view in order to pass the valve or condemn it. That's our process for disassembly. Now we can head over to clean up my components, inspect, and then reassemble. Okay. During During my apprenticeship stage, before I was based here, I was at the Transnet Rail Engineering Training Center as a millwright apprentice. It was a great experience. It was a learning curve because I had no idea what a millwright had to do. I learned quite a lot. It was a completely different environment, different sort of equipment. And when I came through here for training, I used to apply my knowledge learned across at the other department and somehow put it into my daily activity.
Okay, those were the smaller components cleaned by the machine. I just have to clean up the top of this and the inside of the housing before I continue to inspect and then assemble. I might use some screwdrivers just to clean up around.
Should I get this training course, I will still be hands-on, because in order to teach your learners, you have to demonstrate and show them the correct way of doing things before they do it wrong and get hurt. So we'll have to look after them.
And we've got the last one for them. Okay, gaskets are done. We can proceed with the assembly. This gasket will be used now to assemble that component. These two go onto the vessel when we mounting this body back into position. So this will be used at a later stage.
Okay, welcome back, Mr. Avanchal. Thanks for your time. We've got some feedback from your on-the-job assessment that you carried out for us, and the tasks that you did, I was just informed by the assessor, who was Sylvia, to say that you did fairly well, in fact, on all those tasks. Safety was not compromised, which is our first and foremost, one of our highest priorities. All these tasks were done according to the standard operating procedures, or some of them as close as there were one or two gaps. Before I actually move on, let's hear from you. How did you find those three tasks? Firstly, did you find that it was a fair spread of tasks to test the millwright?
Yes, I think it was, because it describes our environment, that we're not limited to just specific tasks, and we're capable of doing anything.
Okay, so overall, we've now come to the point where we need to make a decision on your application for the vacancy of a millwright tutor. The on-the-job part, like I said, went very, very well. You've actually aced it there. In terms of the panel interview questionnaire that we went through, you also did fairly well. There were a few things, but I'm not going to go into the actual detail. What I can tell you is, once a person develops in the training and development field, these questions, you'll find that you'll be actually able to answer much more fully and to a competent level. With that said, I would like to say congratulations to you. You were the suitable candidate with the highest scoring in terms of the millwright vacancy, and well done. Wish you everything of the best, and you'll be hearing from HR very soon in terms of the remuneration package and the rest of the details.
That's great. Thanks.
Okay. Once again, congratulations and all the best in your future as a training officer, Millwright.
I've just come out of the interview right now and I've been successful. I've got the job. I'm really excited. Can't wait to start my new endeavor. This is not the end of the road of my studies. I will definitely further on my training and my development. And to all my hustlers out there, press up, panda, push up. Pressure. come on, okay. Press up, push up, panda.
Well done, Kavish. Re ithutile go wena gore ha ile toro ya hao o tlameha go tswela pele ntse o sebetsa go dimo ha yona go fihlella o ifitlisa pallong. Potso ya rona ya beke ena e tswa go se vuyile. A re yena o batla o tseba ka di learnership tsa SABC mabapi le radio. SABC ina le tsona di learnership tsa broadcasting engineering, TV production, radio production le tse ding. Tsona heba ya di advertiser kumane go di radio tsa bona, di websiteing le maphepheng. Ha o ka sheba ka bo September le bo October. E kopanye le bona ka email. Ha e ka ba gona le go sa utlwang, hopola o checkela Facebook ya rona kapa le yona website.
Halala nsizwa, like a true fisherman, udobeleke umsebenzi omusha. Kwazi bani kuna sikudala, you'll be sitting in your own yard, owning a beach house, bafethu. Yona ke impilo esifunayo sonke lapha emakhaya. Usikhombisile ukuthi ma umuntu, do not go with the flow. Swim against the current, bafethu, to reach your destination like the salmon fish. Kodwa khona manje, sikusikhathi ukuthi manje nginikeze impendulo khona laphana ku word jumbo. Igama kade sifuna yi artisan buffet igama ehlale sisebenzisa khona la ekhaya njengoba ke sinikhombisa ama career noma ke imkhakha ehlukile senze njalo ke naku viki elizayo mina kumfana omntambo ngidonsa zonke intambo sengiphuma kanje akahlaneni ke enkundleni zokuxhumana Twitter, Facebook and YouTube buffet and also our website seneyazi lento buffet ama repeats ango 11 o'clock ngo Thursday ngihlale ngitshele ngithi press up push up panda ungabhekiphansi beka phezulu and stay up.